Hi, hello everyone. Okay, so I think you all know what pour painting is. It's a technique in which you pour some colors on the canvas along with some additives, which allows the paints to flow in a particular manner in which you allow it to flow. Now what happens is the paints that we get are of a particular consistency. Now in order to let them flow, in order for them to flow in a particular manner, you have to add certain additives. Adding water is not sufficient, because what happens is when you add the water, the pigments break. The pigments are not bound by each other, are not bound together. So you need to add certain additive which allow the paint to flow freely. At the same time, the pigments are held together. So now what happens is, now I have seen a lot of videos of Canadian, American and Australian artists. Now the products that they are using, like Floetrol, is not available in India very easily, and even if it is available on Amazon, it's very expensive. So what I have tried is, I have tried to use Indian products as the pore painting medium. Pore painting medium is the additive which you add in the paints, which will allow the paints to flow easily. So I have found some Indian products which I will show them to you. The foreign products also available in India are Liquitex. Now Liquitex is very expensive. It costs around 2,800 or something. And then there is another product, this one. This costs around 1,530 rupees. Now these are very expensive. So what I have found is these products, Acolyte. Okay, this one, and this is another one, base paint. Okay. Now this one is, this one is an untinted base paint. So you have to add your colors in this. This is will act as our pouring medium. We have to add this in our paints and a little water to make it more flowy. Please note this number. Okay, and make a note of this number also. Okay, now the difference between these two is, this I will be using as my flood pillow paint. Okay, the number is APBW11N. Okay, this will be the pillow paint. What is pillow paint? Is the white paint that we spread on the canvas. This costs around 300 rupees. Some of the dealers will give it to you for about 260 rupees. This is APBW22N. This is an untinted base paint. This we will be adding in our colored paints. This will give body to the paints. At the same time, it will make it more flowy. It will not change the color. When you are mixing the colors, it may seem light, but when the canvas dries, the colors will be dark. Now this is how thick this is the pillow paint, white pillow paint. It's okay, baby, it's okay. This is the white pillow paint. Okay, see how thick it is. And this is the base paint in which we will be putting our paints. I'll show you how to mix these paints. Okay. the pillow paint, this is in white in color. I will take a little bit like this. Now see how thick it is. We have to make it more flowy. So I will add a little water. Mix it thoroughly from all the corners. Take the paint from all the corners. This is how fluid it has to be. It has to flow down from the stick like this. Now this is the white pillow paint. Now to mix our colored paints, I'll take a little bit of this cup paint and add this base paint. This base paint holds the pigment together. Now this is very thick. It has to flow continuously from the stick. So we add a little water. Add a little at a time. Add the water little at a time. This is how it should be. This is how the pillow paint and the paints have to be. This is consistency is for these kind of paintings like this. Using these paints. Now these paints are a little more thick than these paints. So you have to add more of the base paint and a little more of the water. First color, Rashi. Now in pore painting, you will find that a lot of cells are formed in the painting because the additive and the colors paints, they mix with each other and form cells. These are the cells. You can see these cells here. Okay. Now some of the artists use silicone oil in the paints in order to get cells. But when I use these two products, I can get cells without adding silicone. You can try painting first without cells, and then you can add the cells and then paint, and you can see what you like. Now what happens with certain silicone oil is it leaves a layer on the canvas, an oily layer on the canvas, so it becomes difficult to varnish or resin the canvas. It becomes a little tacky, the canvas feels a little tacky. So it's possible to get cells without using silicone oil with these two products. So that is, now what happens is you need a torch. Okay, now for this torch will help the bubbles that form on the painting when you are pouring colors. Some certain bubbles are formed. You need to blow them out. With this heat, the bubbles settle down. Otherwise, after they dry, you will find some little dot spots on the painting which do not look good. So you have to remove them. Okay. Now, there are also certain paintings in which you don't need cells at all. Okay. It's a personal choice actually. Some of them like having cells, some of them do not like having cells in their paintings. So you have to experiment. Now, what I have done is I have shot two videos in which I have used these products. I have also explained how I have used these products, and I have shot the video making two paintings. You will understand better when you see those videos how these products are used in these videos. I hope this has helped. I will be making many more such tutorials in which I will use more additives to get this kind of effect. This is called bloom technique. Okay. So I'm working on it. I will make these videos also. I will be making many more videos with many more additives, Indian additives, which are more affordable. Okay. So I hope this has helped. I hope you will use these products and get back to me. Give me your feedback. Comment on what about how this has helped you, whether it has helped you, and how more I can be of help to you. Okay. So in my following videos, you will see the tutorials how I use these products. Okay. So see you soon. Bye.